numbers were good again in New South Wales, and after yesterday's record, a slight respite for Victoria as well.
Everyone good? Standing in the sun? Okay. Well, thank you for coming. I've been joined by the COVID commander,
Drone Weimar, to provide.
Actually, you know what? Let's not. For a while there, COVID press conferences were must-see TV, a depressing daily ritual that turned our leaders into memes.
Beers, 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 get on the beers.
Andrew, I'm sorry. Andrew, I know, but Catherine hasn't had a question. I'm happy to return to you, but let's just keep it civil. Andrew. Catherine, stop it.
The briefings also made our chief health officers into rock stars, complete with some, interesting fan tributes.
My glasses broke, but that's okay. This is a very serious topic, so please don't be distracted by that.
And in dark times, they gave us some truly bizarre moments to lighten the mood.
I find it hard to believe someone was going for a run and then stopped to have a kebab. But in any event...
If you are at Adelaide Oval and the ball comes towards you, my advice to you is to duck and just do not touch that ball.
I don't think the sewage detection is quite that sophisticated to be able to tell whether it's a Canberran's poo or someone else's.
This ball has been touched by many sweaty men out there on the field. Just go and sanitise your hands before you start eating your chips.
But I don't think there's anything wrong. We're not making it unlawful to go for a run and eat a kebab.
Does John know something about the poo that other people don't?
2020, it's full of surprises.
But to be honest, even in New South Wales and Victoria, you probably started tuning out a while ago. Gladys certainly did.
I'll turn up when I need to. To do this every day means that I'm not doing my job properly.
That didn't age well. Awkward. They're still fronting up in Victoria, but some Melbourne doctors reckon messaging like this...
It's selfish. They are shitty choices.
Could be doing more harm than good.
I do worry that with the focus on individual behaviours, it might make people worry that they're going to get in trouble if they seek help. It's really important for people to know that when they seek healthcare for this, that we are here to help, not to judge.
Frankly, I think they need to go. I haven't listened to them for months. I don't like the tone of them.
So is it finally time for last questions?
There never is last questions, is there really?
You don't run the press conference, OK?
Again, just a reminder, a couple of years ago, who would have heard that much from their state premiers? Like, what an effort every day, day after day. No wonder funny thing, you know, random things got said over that time. Because it's live and it's, you know, questions coming at you.
I think journalists still need to be able to have a forum where they can do their jobs and get that information, but I wonder if we all need to be watching them. I guess it's a personal choice because, I mean, I checked out of them about a month ago and I've got to say my own mental health has been a lot better for doing that. I felt like I was waiting around for them and then kind of getting halfway through them and going, well, what the point is this? I've wasted the morning.
Yes.
And I checked out. It's been good.
But I reckon they don't need to be every day. Like, journalists can do their jobs without a press conference. They do that every day, actually. They don't wait for a press conference before they report.
But wasn't it interesting that when it was daily, they couldn't hide from any of the things that may have been brewing versus if there was stuff that they were going to get asked on, well, we're just not doing a presser today, you know, whereas it gave journalists a chance every day to make to be on them, you know?
Except didn't you find, I mean, I personally found that it was the same thing every day. So after a while, actually, it wasn't holding them to account. It kind of became, for me anyway, like political theatre. We just tune into this thing, we watch them go back and forth, social media lights up in the very predictable ways that it does, and then we move on. Like, sometimes I actually think a story breaking properly would have more impact.
I don't know. I mean, I can't think of them now, but I feel like there were many moments where it was through a journalist question at one of those daily press conferences that we found out something, you know, really interesting or learnt more about the quarantine debacle or about whatever it was, you know. Anyway, but I think there has to be a time when they come to an end and they focus on rebuilding these states.
So they might need to ramp back up because we're about to move into a different stage of the COVID experience, you know, the living with COVID experience when we can't, all the vaccination rates are hit. And then there's going to be new information of how we're travelling and maybe there'll be things we need to follow up with that.
Probably right.
Have you missed them, Rach?
No, heck no. But, I think that they're probably a sign of bad news too. So if we get them back, it'll probably be because when we open up again, there's something's gone wrong and we need to see them again. So it's been nice to step out and to focus on the vaccination numbers instead of, you know, daily case numbers, which I think we all have to do if we're going to move forward and live with COVID, you know.
And our thoughts with everyone at North Face as well.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.